Legion's fucking Sonic fucking 4 episode fucking 1. And I'm gonna tell you and start with the most important thing, the character design. When you first start this game, you get the classic Sega jingle and you see the fucking green eyed fucking shit run across the screen, shooting the fucking classic Sonic. And then when you fucking enter and you see the start screen, the green eyed Sonic comes in the emblem, which is the worst fucking emblem ever. But guess what? They actually put a little effort in the title screen. They make a move and then they make him wag his finger, which was like Sonic 1 a little bit, but at least they didn't like make it stale and make it frozen like fucking in the beta version. I mean, what the fuck? And when you first start this game, the music is pretty catchy. It's fucking awesome. It reminds you of the fucking classic fucking days, and it's fucking good. But when you fucking start Splash Hill Zone, the controls are not like the fucking classics. I mean, maybe the running is a little bit like it, but nothing is like it. You fucking do a fucking spin dash, you slow down whenever you get far enough. You fucking go off a fucking ramp, you uncurl in a ball, and it's forced a fucking homing attack on you. I mean, what the fuck? In the classics, when you go off a fucking ramp, you stay in a fucking ball. I mean, what the fuck? You need to fucking change that. And this is what gets me the most. When you fucking walk as Sonic, you fucking see his quills get shorter. But when you fucking start running faster, they get fucking longer as fuck. I mean, what the fuck? You should fucking put the fucking classic side and just fucking use that. I mean, what the fuck? Why do we have to have this fucking green light shit? I don't care if it's fucking 2010. Mega Man 9 used the fucking classic Mega Man. It could have been successful with a Sonic 1 Sonic. They need to put a download fucking patch for it. And let's see, the Splash Hill Zone act music is pretty good. They didn't rush it. They used three different tracks with three different fucking acts. And the boss music is kind of fucking missing a point. But it's fucking, it fits it alright, I guess, because Eggman is a fucking clown. And so is Robotnik. It's just fucking stupid. They should have fucking named him Robotnik. They should have fucking put the classic Sonic. But at least they used the Sonic 1 boss. That's fucking awesome. Now, the special stages. What the fuck? They're fucking hard as fucking hell. But anyways, I beat all the fucking special stages. It's fucking stupid. I mean, it's Sonic 1 special stages, which is okay. I'm great at Sonic 1, so I beat all these special stages on the first fucking day. And I got all the fucking emeralds and I turned fucking Super Sonic. And Super Sonic plays just like in the fucking classics. Unstoppable is fast, but you don't get to go to the boss. There's a boss act, which is kind of smart in a way, but it doesn't resemble the classics. There's a boss act, I fucking think, because they don't want you to fucking cheat it with Super Sonic and just fucking stand there, I guess. I don't know, fucking use fucking skill, which I have in Sonic 1 all the time. I beat that game no deaths, all the emeralds, and have like 21 lives at the end because I'm fucking awesome at that game. Anyways, fucking, in this fucking game, the music is alright. And then you get the Casino Street Zone. It's fucking like a rip off of Sonic 2, but they fucking use Act 2 and change it to a fucking card, which is cool. I mean, it's the longest act in the game, I think, is the fucking card zone. And it's a good act. You get fucking, what, 50 lives in that fucking level? I mean, what the fuck? They should fucking put fucking challenge in this game, because I already have like 150 fucking lives in this fucking game. I mean, what the fuck? And the fucking Act 3 is the cannons, which is pretty fucking fun. But the physics in this game, it's fucking weird. I mean, you can run slow as fucking Sonic will climb a fucking wall like fucking Spider-Man. They should make it fucking Spider-Man throw with hentai quills. I mean, what the fuck? And fucking, what's the third zone in this game? Oh yeah, Lost Labyrinth Zone, which is a Labyrinth Zone ripoff of Sonic 1, which is okay in my book, because Sonic 1 is the best Sonic game, and I fucking own this zone, I own it so bad, it's easy as fuck. I mean, what the fuck, the bad nicks in this game fucking rock, they look awesome, they're cool, I'm glad they brought the fucking bad nicks back. And, but what really gets me is the fucking leader fucking boards. I mean, what the fuck, it's fucking hack shit, 0-0 for time, and like fucking, and the other thing for a score attack, 9-9-9-9-9-0, what the fuck, fucking hackers, cheaters, fuckers. And then you get fucking Mad Gear Zone, which has good music, and stuff, and it's really cheap as fuck. But guess what, you kill the fucking Shellcrackers easy as fuck now, and the fucking Slicers, I think. And the fucking Starfish don't even hit you anymore. I mean, what the fuck? They made it so easy that they fucking hold the fucking hand to the fucking game, the fucking homing fucking attack. They should fucking took the fucking homing fucking attack out of this fucking game, fucking ruined it, makes it fucking easy as fuck. But the fucking boss at the end of fucking Mad Gear Zone, the fucking Sonic 2 rehash, and then the fucking twist is fucking the body run away. But the fucking Egg Station Zone, it's fucking four bosses from the first four levels of the game, and then get to the fucking final boss, it's the Sonic 2 rehash, but it has a twist. He goes in fucking berserk mode, shoots his arm, shoots a laser out of his eye, shoots balls out of his head, and then when you fucking get to the last hit, he fucking tries to break the fucking platform, so you move out of the fuck away until he doesn't have electricity on him, and then you hit him, and then you beat the fucking game. And you can also collect all the fucking rings at the fucking end of the fucking stage, in the fucking little scene where Sonic is running, you can collect all those fucking rings and get a fucking Sonic avatar head for your fucking Xbox 360 avatar. And then when you fucking beat the game, it's the Sonic 1 ending, sort of, but when you get the fucking all chaos emeralds, they don't have like the Sonic 1 ending where they fucking put all the chaos emeralds in the air and make flowers around Green Hill Zone. He just fucking jumps up in the air like it's the bad ending in Sonic 1, the same ending, but the only fucking difference is the fucking episode 2 teaser. What the fuck? It's a fucking teaser! It's a fucking picture of fucking metal fucking Sonic showing glowing red eyes and fucking Eggman laughing! That's a fucking teaser! I mean, what the fuck? But overall, this game has turned out to be a good game. And after all, it only has Sonic and Dark Robotnik, and that's it! In episode 2, they better have fucking Tails and Nigger Knuckles! But I doubt that, because the fucking cutscene at the fucking Egg Station to get there has a fucking Tails rocket symbol on it, so it symbolizes that fucking faggot Tails is gonna be in episode fucking 2, and also connected with episode fucking 1! I mean, what the fuck? But the best part about this game, the best fucking part, is the fucking loading screen! Holy fucking shit! The Sonic 1 Sonic, the best Sonic, and also the fucking life thing when you beat the level, and also the life thing when you beat a level at the bonus stage, has a fucking Sonic 1 continue sprite! It fucking rocks! This game gets a 6.5 out of 10. It overall becomes a good game in my book. So it's another good game to add to your list to play in video games. So get Tails in video games, play